Moin zusammen! Before we start, you may already notice that the title of this video and my voice are a bit different compared to last time. Yes, my friend, this time the video is in English. I hope my German friends are fine with that and my international audience will excuse my crappy English.
I only understand railroad station.
And now, let us begin. After I referred to the 890 Duke R in my monster video, your interest was so great. Of course, I have to take care of that Austrian. At the beginning of 2020, KTM presented the new 890 Duke R. And the internet. He really dares to mess with the Kiska design? Oh yes, he dares. But not at the Duke R. Because recently KTM finally presented the 890 Duke without R. It replaces the 790 Duke and expands the 890 range with a base model. Fortunately, I didn't start with this video earlier, because the Not R already makes one thing better in my eyes. Good for me, less to do, bad for you, shorter video. But let's take a closer look first. I have to apologize in advance for the poor picture quality. But KTM believes that this pixel mess is sufficient in 2021 for press motives. No, KTM, it's not. Or they might have fulfilled this video. Anyways, at first visual glance, everything remains the same. Identical engine, identical frame, identical tank. The technical difference should be explained to you by someone else. KTM's marketing speech calls the 890 Duke the scalpel. It not only drives with surgical precision, but is also drawn with it. The Kiska design impresses with its clear and unadorned lines, with a combination of sharp-edged and round shapes. Although the design is quite reduced, it is anything but boring. Above all, the bug eye has established itself across all KTM models for years. I won't even dare to touch it. Duke fans have had to get used to moving away from the trailies frame since the 790, which is why this model also has a somewhat simple but functional frame of the 890R. Except for the side panels that are stretched quite forward, in my opinion the Duke meets the definition of a naked bike with every screw, reduced to the bare minimum and no frills whatsoever. But that wasn't always the case. The Duke has always been a bit long-legged. The 690 Duke 3 in particular had more of a supermoto than a naked bike. And there we come straight to the first and biggest point of criticism. The remaining relic from the old days. The too high mounted and elongated muffler. Come on, it looks like an adventure bike or even enduro. And even there, they are mounted lower. From a distance, the silhouette also merges into a bulky rear. It looks kind of weird, especially from the left. But one thing I will give KTM that. The muffler fits smoothly onto the rear. Still, we have to adjust the position and shape. First, we get rid of that thing. Of course KTM shows the accessory muffler from Akrapovic in its promo video, but it doesn't change the fact that the stock bike has this party horn shape thing. I do like the muffler from the Super Duke better, so let's bring it on. Call me conservative, but in my world the muffler on a naked bike belongs down there, so we stick it to the collector down below. We are also making it a bit slimmer and longer. Just a little bit darker. Much better. The silhouette looks way slimmer and the tight rear comes to its own. And of course, also in this perspective. That looks nice. But we are not done yet. As neatly and straight the manifold is, I find it too boring. And even though I always preach in the comments that I try to create a possible stock condition, actually the accessories catalog has an appropriate solution. The titanium exhaust system from Akrapovich. Look at this beautiful swing. We just take the part where both pipes run together. The rest remains the same. After all, you can already order this kit as it is. And I do like that the manifold first swings to the left side of the bike. So you have at least something to look at on that side too. Otherwise, bikes always look best from the right side. Oh yeah, now we're talking. Now in profile 2. Done. When I now look at the entire exhaust system, I notice that these protruding pillion foot pegs are no longer necessary. And before, they were also removable. Chapeau KTM, by the way. But now I attached the muffler on it. Let's create a lower mount and shorter foot pegs. The Super Duke may donate the right parts again. Yes, that looks even better. And the rear foot pegs can be removed again if required. And also in this perspective. Done. Let's get to the rear, or pillion seat if you will. KTM just got their act together and swapped the weird seat cover of the R for an actually decent seat. And to be honest, I actually think it's prettier. Unlikely my monster. With the cover on, it's just beautiful. And of course, with the seat, it becomes also more luggage friendly. Against probably all expectations, we are still only looking at the rear of the Duke. And so with the next point. Let's play a quiz. What do the old BMW R80 GS and the 890 Duke have in common?
Raus damit, du Sau!
The rear light integrated into the splash guard. Honestly, who else still does that? Except for BMW 40 years ago. As with the Super Duke, the rear light should be integrated into the rear. And while we are at it, we will also take the more elegant and slimmer splash guard. And finally, I would like to fix the seat position just a little bit. I love the slightly forward-leaning posture on my Monster. The longer tank moves the seat slightly backwards. In comparison, you sit much more upright on the KTM, as the tank is shorter and steeper in front of the driver. If I stretch the tank a little longer, it should lead to a forward-leaning posture. And it also looks a little less humped. Done. And to be honest, that's it. I wouldn't want to change one more thing. I would love to own such a bike and might even trade my Monster for that. What do you think of the design of the new 890 Duke and my corrections? Please write it down in the comments. Thanks for watching. subscribe for more videos. Until next time.
Your English is under all pick. I have the nose full, painted full.